Hiya. Let's move the camera closer. Adding bits to this boat now. Let's see if we can. Okay, that's nice. Wondering if the paint had dried yet, but it's not, so that's good. We can use it. Is it raining? Thought I could hear rain outside. Okay. This is just some highlight brown and midnight black mixed together. Okay. Let's grab this. Right now, take this little roll of paint now. Okay. Right here. Put a little thing on the top, you know, where the guy can come along, and when he's fishing, when he's in his boat, well, if it's raining, you want someone to put you in, you want to get in under there. I'll just see what happens. So, more paint. Up. There we go. Just putting in the basic shape foundation for the little room that's going on. Okay. Come on the small edge of the knife and just get this bottom bit done here. Just get the bottom. There we go. Now that all goes together nicely. Okay. Now that we've got general shape of what's going on now. General shape. We will use a fan brush, because fan brushes are always fun. Which shall we use? That's a filbert. Two fan brushes here. Three. Okay. It's hiding on my desk. Hiding in plain sight. Right. Okay, so take some white paint. Titanium white. this one. I'll have some of that. Yeah. Burnt umber. There's a bit of burnt sienna on already on the canvas palette. Sorry. Okay. Touch of blue. Right, so I have the Prussian blue, because that's the one that I had in my hand. And it's a very nice colour. I like this one a lot. Not much of it. Just enough. I'll just put a bit more on so that we can play about. I'll have that greyish tone. Greyish, woodish type tone. Okay. So, first of all, we should definitely just go into the white. Pull that out. Get a touch of the sienna and the umber. Play that into it. Just a little bit. Right, and then come in and we'll start making bits of shape. Little splinters of wood going across, so. Okay. Splinters of wood. Go back into the paint. Picked up some dark there. Okay. And some on this side. Okay. Some of the blue that we just took, mix that into the white, so it's quite light, and up here to the black and brown. You can't see what I'm doing because I'm up here. Okay, there we are, and then we'll put that into the blue and the black that we just had. Need a bit more, the white and the blue, sorry. Need a bit more of the dark. Okay, that's nice. This colour, all these colours. Okay, we're getting a nice greyish colour here. A bit more of the sienna and umber in that. Just to get a bit of a brownish hue. And we'll come in here and we'll give some more indications of stuff happening. Just on a few. Right here. The fan brush is nice for this because it brings shape. It brings shape to the wood. Just do a bit more of the dark greyish colour. Or light greyish colour. I said dark because I was looking at the colour that I'm coming on to. Right. Splinters of wood here. Now, just here and now, we'll see where this light's coming in like this, so we'll just have a few more shiny bits on this side. So we'll pull them in. Going into the umber and sienna and mixing it with white. straighten this up a little. Oh yeah, pulled a bit too much with the fan brush, but that's okay. You just make it slightly bigger. Right, well, now that we've done that, we can come back to the knife. Pull some flat on it. No, flat, same thing. And then maybe he's got, well, it's no use having a little house covering from rain if you can't get in it, so we'll put the little door that you can walk into there. Now this is on, we're looking at this from an angle, don't forget, so you're not going to see the whole thing. Just basic idea of where it is. If I get it straight, that'll be fine. Just define the little more. There we go. Alright. And when he's in there, he wants to see outside. Otherwise he'll not be able to see where he's going. So, we'll do two little windowy things on the front there. Two little, whatever you want to call them, windows, yeah. Portholes. That's not what they are, but we'll call them that if we want to. You can call it whatever you want. As long as you know what it is, then it's fine. This lightish brownish glasses, sienna number. Mix that with some of this red here. Okay. And we'll just boop. Take a small bit on the top. And then we'll come across here and give him a little hat on this cabin. And have a little hat on. The rain's gonna get in, and we don't want the rain getting in, do we? We don't want that, no. So, there's his little hat. Okay. Just neaten it up a little. I'm just gonna make a touch more. Touch more. I have some on top of these posts here as well. Just. There we go. That's a nice colour now. That's some interesting colour happening. Okay, should we have some here? Just a little more. Take and just there we go. Now then. Side. Want some paint out flat. Where's my paper towel? There it is. And just, sorry if that was a very crazy noise. We can see where that door is. That. Right, yeah, I think we're about done with that part. Now, we will grab some more of this. Now then, this is a big decision point here. I'm going to have some masts coming up. Can you see if I've got some? Okay, well, where are we going with this? There'll be one around there-ish. One around here. Well, we've already got a beam going up, so... Right, let's see. Well, he lives there now. He didn't before. That's where he is. Very hard to see until we put the highlights on. Okay, little top to this mask. Okay. Okay, and then on the other side. Where is he? Where are we having this one? Yes. Oh, that one's there. That's it. Could be a little bit shorter than that one. So, I think we'll go straight into that tree there. Right into him. Well, we can't change our mind now. Everything's okay. Everything's fantastic. Don't worry about it. There we go. Just a bit more color. My knife wasn't pulling up all the color then, so I just put it back on the palette and pick it back up. Because when you're using the knife, starts to go flat on the end of the knife. Put it back on the palette, pick it back up again, and then you've got it nice and proud. Okay. Yeah, just put a little doer on him as well. There we go. There he is. Okay. Sienna and white, a bit more white. Perhaps a touch of that greyish colour as well, just for fun. There's a bit of red in there. Right. Well, of course. We'll do this one first. On the top bit there. There we go. Doing their own thing. The dry piece of paint here that's in the way. Let me fix that, shall we? Alright, so this window. Paint's dried on it, so just gently scratch the paint off. Back over, remake the window. Yep, no problem. Easy peasy. clean this up a little so we don't. Oh, we don't have any anything crazy happening that we don't want to happen. Sometimes we want crazy things to happen. But this isn't one of them. Alrighty. Back into our corner. Making lots of racket. Look all the way out, right. Dark. Quite a lot of dark, because I need to fix that window. Can have some of that too. Okay. And, alright, I've just noticed that this window is just a bit smaller than the knife. So we will use the smaller knife. Which is a little more flimsy, and that's okay. Once you get the hang of it, then it's fine. Okay. Just come straight in with that. Okay. Bottom. Using the small edge of the small knife now. Perhaps we could just boop. That makes more sense, doesn't it? And then we will just dab a little indications there so that we can come in with some lighter colour. And miss. Hold on, that's a good point. Outline the edges here. Okay. And then do. Again, a little bit of dry paint in the way, but not to worry. Yeah, the brown's dry really fast. Okay, back in with some of that. Nice, pretty highlighted colour. There we go. Into the dark, pulled some of the dark into the grey colour. So we've got like a dark grey to clean this area up so this looks a little more together. It's an interesting post. Okay. Righty out. Now, let's gather this. So there's the sienna on the right and some brown. Make some room. My knife on the paper towel there. Now, put some dark up there.